Good morning. Today we are going to discuss a program which accepts input from a user and it checks whether a given number is even or odd. And the next thing is that the process of accepting input from user and verifying whether it's even or odd continues unless user press 0. So, I have already included this header file stdio.h. Now, within main, we have taken a variable num type integer where we will store the value entered by the user. Here are the masses for the user, enter number, printf. This will be when you will program, it will display enter number and user will enter any value. And using scanf, the entered value will be stored in num. Ampersand is used here to store the value at this address. It's called address of operator. Okay. Now come on to the verification section or checking section whether it's number is even or odd. We'll talk about the while loop later. First, see how we can check it. So we are using if else block. To check whether a number is even or odd. Num mod 2 is equal to 0. Num, as you already aware, mod returns the remainder. So once you use this operator and say the value is 10. So 10 mod 2, it will return you 0. And the 0 will be compared with 0. So it is 0, it returns 0 when the number is even. It will display it, the condition is true, it will display the masses number is even. And in case odd number is there, say 11, 11 mod 2, it will return you 1. So 1 is compared with 0, condition is false. So it will go to the else block. So number is odd will be displayed on the screen. So these statements are used to check whether a given number is even or odd. Now the question says that we have to continue the process unless user enters 0. So again we have to accept input from user, ask user to enter another number and just put slash n so that it can be displayed in the next line. Enter a number and this will accept the number. Now this number will now it will take you to the beginning of the loop, that is the condition section. Now it will check whether the number is 0 or not. If the number is 0, the loop will be terminated. You can go inside the loop only if the number is non-zero. Okay, so how it will run when you will enter compile and run the program, it will flash some messages, enter a number. User will enter the number. Now it will go and check. If it is non-zero, it will take you inside the loop. And say it's 10, so you are inside the loop. Condition is true because 10 is not equal to 0. So you are inside the loop. It will check whether it's true or false. So condition is true. As 10 is even number, so it will display you number is even. And then again it will flash a message, enter a number. Okay. So again, user will be prompted to enter a number. User will enter a number. Say this time user entered 20. So it will return back here and check whether number is not equal to 0. So 20 is not equal to 0. Its condition is true. Here again, process will be repeated. Again, user will be asked to enter a number. Say this time user enters 0. What will happen? 0 is not equal to 0. So condition is false because 0 is equal to 0. So you are taken outside the loop and it will go to getch. So let's compile the program and run it and see what is happening. So it you have to enter a number, say 10. Number is even. Now again you are asked to enter a number. Let's enter 11. Number is odd. Say enter 12. Number is even. Enter 13, number is odd. Enter 17, number is odd. And enter 80, number is even, and say I now entered 0, what will happen? Program is terminated. You are outside the program. So this is all about how to check the number whether it's even or an odd, and you will be prompted again to enter a number, and the process will continue unless 0 is entered by the user. Thanks for now.